The Philippine Stock Exchange closes lower on Wednesday. The main index down by 1.13%, sliding back to the 6,400 level. Value turnover, however, climbed significantly to 11.45 billion pesos. To help us make sense of today's market movements, we're now joined by Manu Castro, equity analyst at Regina Capital. Manu, again, good afternoon. Thanks for joining us.
Good afternoon, Stan. Glad to be back.
Yes, pretty bad numbers we saw today, 1.13% down, settling again convincingly at the 6,400 level. We finished at 6,434. Now, Manu, without any catalysts to prop it up in the near future, how do you see trading ending the week?
It seems that all the indicators are leaning towards having the index settling at the red during this shortened trading week. We're not anticipating any local data to come out this week. So it's going to appear like this is going to be on autopilot, which theoretically, this means that we're supposed to be following the performance of the global markets. But after today's trading, it does not seem to be the case as investors are flocking back to the US.
And of course, when it is on autopilot, it's hard to pick stocks that really excel or stand out. But given then, what were the most popular issues today and why do you think they were being bought or sold?
There has been some high volume around the Gokongwei Group. JGS as well as RRHI are both of the most actively traded stocks during this trading session. We see a cross by AB Cap. We're not quite sure as to what the reason would be behind this. There has been no disclosure yet so far, but there must be something going on.
Okay, we of course saw volume exceeding the usual at 11K. That's quite big. Aside from JGS, were there other transactions worth noting today?
We could link this high volume due to the result of the economic data that was released yesterday in the U.S. We saw inflation hit its lowest levels since 2021. Mm-hmm. So we're seeing the market being especially active after this U.S. report.
Okay, at about the same time that was happening, foreign direct investment, news and data about it in the Philippines, not quite encouraging. In fact, it's plunging amid global worries over inflation and long-term growth. Now, are we still at net foreign selling as of today? Because that has been the trend in the past days.
Yeah, based on today's market performance, we could see that we're on a net foreign sell. And one of the main reasons behind this is that it is likely that the investors are shifting to the U.S. market on hopes that the U.S. would most likely put a pause into their rates and making this a much more attractive market.
And the U.S. market's been bullish, of course, in the past days. Let's look at our corporate stories now. Manu, talking about Globe, which was saying and hinting keen interest to list GCash finally, but said nothing is final yet with timelines, but its fintech unit is supposed to be ready for public fundraising. Also, competitor PLDT eyeing to raise capital for Maya along the lines of foreign investments and even a possible IPO. Now, what's the future for fintech as far as capability to adding shareholder value, and what kind of growth perhaps are you seeing in this space?
Yeah, fintech is actually an attractive sector, one that especially ballooned during the pandemic. And as a result of this, we see the fintech becoming much more around. So in growing these businesses, for example, it's going to take some time for them to reach profitability, such as in the case of Maya under Voyager, which is not expected to be profitable till the end of next year. But in general, the fintech industry still continues to grow, as we're seeing consumers make use of more digital ways in their transactions. And we're seeing this become more integrated in our daily lives.
Yes, I've been seeing a lot of positive news on the IPO front, although nothing is really confirmed except for Ovia Land, which months before was scheduled to go public this year. But it is pushing back IPO plans to 2024, citing unfavorable market conditions. Now, what other IPOs now are there to look forward to? As we know for a fact that we're already entering the remaining 6 months of 2023 because the PSE would have targeted over 10 or 14 this year. Do you think that goal is still achievable?
Well, I think it's just strategic for the firms to postpone their IPO listings all around while the global growth prospects seem to be decelerating. So the investors' appetite still seems to be pretty lukewarm when it comes to the market, and they are on this risk-off mode, probably heavy on cash or also probably still heavy on fixed income. So I expect more IPOs to defer on later dates. I can't really say for sure if we're going to be able to achieve 10 IPOs by the end of the year, but I do think that firms would have to wait for more bullish sentiment before they finally list on the exchange.
All right. On that note, Manu Castro of Regina Capital, thank you so much for your market guidance. Have a good day.
Thank you.